My name is Daria Filipponi. First of all, I would like to thanks for this opportunity to present my work and to participate to this international conference. The title of the talk is DNA damage signaling induce cancer cell reprogramming as a driver of tumor relapse. DNA damage response that I will call DDR signaling is a signaling pathway that has evolved to protect our genome from the stress. It has been implicated in the negative regulation of cell cycle, induction of apoptosis, and senescence. Evidence from cancer-prone mouse model support the role of this pathway in delayed onset of cancer. In human, activation of DDR represents an important early step in suppression of tumorigenesis. WEE1, that is for wild-type 53-induced phosphatase, has been implicated in the regulation of DDR signaling pathway. Loss of WEE1 results in a constitutive activation of DDR via upregulation of sensor proteins such as ATM and ATR. In this context, a genetic model of WEE1 knockdown or deletion represents a powerful tool to manipulate the level of DNA damage signaling in mouse and in human. And this may provide novel insight into our understanding of tumorigenesis. Our analysis of several well-characterized mouse cancer models show, in fact, that deletion of WEE1 results in suppression of tumorigenesis in several types of cancer. The tumor-resistant phenotype of WEE1 relies mostly on activation of DDR signaling, consistent with the role of DDR in suppression of tumorigenesis. This prompts us to speculate that activation of DDR signaling could be, in principle, able to delay the onset of relapse after chemotherapy treatment. Surprisingly, our analysis of MMIC-driven lymphoma showed that WEE1-deficient mice are resistant to tumorigenesis, but tumor relapse much faster than wild type, highlight a new paradigm of DNA damage signaling, suppressing primary cancer but accelerating tumor relapse. Using WEE1 knockout as a genetic tool to modulate DNA damage response, we previously described how the epigenetic landscape of a cancer cell changes when DDR is induced. The major findings that the induction of DDR contribute to the epigenetic remodeling by targeting the DNA methylation machinery on heterochromatin-associated sequence, such as retroelement, and this event induces their transcriptional silencing. To investigate forward the potential role of DDR in a tumor progression at molecular level, we perform a microarray analysis in wild type and WEE1 depleted background. Gene set enrichment analysis showed that the activation of several tumor suppressor pathways upon WEE1 deletion. But surprisingly, we also observe an upregulation of several genes that represent different oncogenic and cancer-promoting pathways. Both groups of genes were regulated by DDR signaling. For further analysis, we focus on the mechanisms that may drive late stage of tumorigenesis. Specifically, tumor relapse has been associated with the formation of a subset of cells with unique properties, including cancer stem cells, and in turn, several transcription factors that are critical in embryonic stem cell maintenance have been found enriched in cancer stem cells, including OCT4A. For this reason, we design specific primer in order to discriminate between the three major OCT4 isoforms, OCT4A, OCT4B, and OCT4B1. And our analysis showed that activation of DDR signaling clearly has an impact on OCT4 locus. Since OCT4 locus is regulated by DNA methylation in somatic cells, we next check whether activation of DDR could impact the level of DNA methylation on OCT4 locus. Gene walking analysis showed that induction of DDR reduce the level of DNA methylation on the locus, and this event epigenetically reactivate OCT4. At molecular level, we found that DDR signaling poised a series of epigenetic events resulting in activation of protumorigenic gene, but can go as far as a reactivation of pluripotency gene OCT4. Loss of DNA methylation appear to be the key initiating event in DDR-dependent OCT4 locus reactivation. To evaluate the reactivation of OCT4 locus in vivo, next we perform genetic line stressing experiment using a tamoxifen-inducible mouse line in which the CRE-RT2 was knocked into the OCT4 locus. We crossed these mice with a ROSA26 LAZ reporter line and subsequently with the EMU-MIC transgenic mice. The EMU-MIC transgenic mice is a non-cancer stem cell model of B-cell lymphoma in which any cancer cells can give rise to lymphoma in a transplantation assay. Once tumor develop, we inject these mice with the tamoxifen, and 1 week later we sacrifice those mice and perform the X-GAL staining. Our analysis show no line stressing in primary tumor, suggesting that the reactivation of OCT4 locus in primary tumor does not occur. Next, we investigate whether OCT4 expressing cell can appear in response to cancer treatment. For this aim, we use a single cyclophosphamide treatment on developed lymphoma. 1 week later, we inject tamoxifen and then we wait for relapse. When relapse occurs, we sacrifice the mice and we perform the X-GAL staining. So for this set of experiment, we use two group of animal, EMU-MIC OCT4 CRE-RT2 ROSA26 and EMU-MIC ROSA26 without OCT4. We allow both these animal, these two group of animal, to develop lymphoma, and then we treat them with the cyclophosphamide. After 1 week, we inject with the tamoxifen and we wait for tumor relapse and we perform the X-GAL staining. Our analysis show that all the cells or the bulk of the cells of relapsed lymphoma were positive for the X-GAL staining, specifically in mice having OCT4 but not in the control animal, suggesting that the relapsed tumor originate from OCT4 expressing cells. Next, to verify that OCT4 expression was critical for tumor relapse, we turn our analysis on OCT4 conditional knockout. For the same, we cross this OCT4 conditional knockout with ROSA26 CRE-RT2 animal, and subsequently we bred them with EMU-MIC transgenic mice. So for this set of experiment, we use three experimental group: the wild type animal, the heterozygote, that is OCT4 conditional knockout in heterozygote configuration, and the knockout, that is OCT4 conditional knockout in homozygote configuration. So we analyze all the three group of animal, and we show that there was no difference in the primary tumor between the group, indicating that OCT4 expressing cells do not contribute to the primary tumor grow in vivo. In sharp contrast, we found that tumor recurrence after cyclophosphamide treatment was significantly delayed in OCT4 knockout mice, showing that OCT4 expressing cancer cells are responsible for the tumor relapse. To provide evidence that OCT4 reactivation in human primary cancer in response to DDR, we next generate a genetic line stressing tool with the CRISPR-Cas9 method. With this method, we integrate the CRE-RT2 cassette into the endogenous locus of OCT4, and we couple that with a turbo green reporter system that allow to visualize the OCT4 expressing cells and their progeny in green. For this set of experiment, we focus on cancer types that do not show a significant demethylation of four locus, and this to evaluate the full impact of DNA damage on the locus reactivation. For that reason, we first establish primary cells from the lung adenocarcinoma patients. Next, we integrate the lineage tracing system into these cells, and in another moment, we injected those cells into nude mice to grow tumor orthotopically into the lung. 7 days later, one group of mice were treated with cisplatinum, another group were leave untreated, and a day later, both group of mice were injected with tamoxifen to follow the lineage tracing. Our analysis of lineage tracing revealed the appearance of progeny of OCT4 positive cells. This effect was increased after the treatment with cisplatinum, but most importantly, a stable depletion of ATM with a short terpene RNA efficiently reversed OCT4 reactivation after cisplatinum treatment, indicating that OCT4 expression is induced by DDR and modulate the response to chemotherapy in the primary tumor. Recent clinical and preclinical data support the view that cancer is hierarchically organized with a small number of cells, the cancer stem cell, that sit on top of such a hierarchy. These cancer stem cells are linked to tumor growth and to relapse. However, it's not clear whether such capability is a feature that belongs only to a stable population within the cells, or if can also reflect a transient state that is acquired during the cancer treatment. The reprogramming event described here provides a strong evidence that chemotherapy-induced DDR signaling can play a primary role in epigenetic reprogramming of cancer cells that can go as far as the reactivation of early embryonic stem cell gene, including OCT4. This epigenetically induced stem cell-like state contributes to the acquisition of drug resistance and tumor relapse in mouse model as well as in human patients. This work supports a model of clonal evolution of cancer in which a therapy-induced epigenetic remodeling could promote a selective advantage in a subset of cancer cells during cancer treatment and drive relapse. In this case, all the cells that experience this transient state may have a similar possibility to survive the therapy and regrow the tumor independently from any intrinsic established hierarchy. In this case, this alternative model could drive relapse and could be particularly relevant to identify new entry point for the therapeutic approach. Thanks a lot for your attention.